Hello friends, so today's video is about identifying genuine Shami plants, as there is lots of confusion on online platforms as well as YouTube on videos regarding identification of genuine Shami, and the videos which are talking about its benefits as well are showing the wrong image. So that's why I came up with this video, did a thorough research. Please stay with end of the video so that you can get a complete clarification on how to identify yourself a genuine Shami plant. So to start with, a lot of confusing and wrong information prevails on major e-commerce platforms, and only a few sellers are selling genuine Shami plants. So you can see this is a Flipkart image, and here we are looking at a seller who is selling Shami plants, and you can see the color here of the flower. It has bicolor, it has pink and yellow color, and Shami plants have only yellow colored flowers. So this is not a genuine Shami, and its leaf also tells us that it's not a genuine image of the Shami plant. So if the image is not proper, then you cannot trust whether seller is selling the right Shami plant, because he himself is not clear about its real identity. So this is not a Shami plant, it's Virtaru. So Shami's other images tells us that here also a lot of sellers are selling Virtaru, which, and this is not a genuine Shami plant. None of them is a Shami plant, as evident from its leaf morphology, how its leaf looks, how its branches are looking, how its flower colors are shown in the picture. So moving over to another image of Flipkart, here we are not again we don't have a genuine Shami plant, but we are looking at a other plant which look very close to Shami plant, and this one has flowers also in yellow color as Shami has, but there is some difference based on which I can tell it's Kabuli Kikar or Vilayati Babool, but it's not Shami plant. So later in the video we will explain you how yourself you can identify a Shami plant. Even if it is a small plant, it's a small plantlet, not a tree. A tree can be easily identified based on flowers, but when you buy a small plant, there is no flower in it. So that's why you need a guidance wherein you can identify plant at initial level based on certain features. Now, what are those features based on which you can identify the genuine Shami plant will be explained further in the video. But let's see more of confusion which has been very prevalent on internet. So this is a screenshot from Amazon, and here as well you see all the Shami sellers are not selling genuine Shami. It's actually Virtaru, which is called Dichrostachys cinerea, and real Shami is Prosopis cinerea. They are using right biological name, but still this is not a genuine Shami, it's Virtaru. This is a real Shami. One of the sellers on Amazon is selling a real Shami, and based on its morphology and leaf pattern, we can say that yeah, it is a genuine Shami plant. Then another major e-commerce platform which is totally focused on selling plants, Nursery Live, is also selling genuine Shami plants. So this is also real Shami. Now all my viewers who are having a trust on me can stop the video here itself and order Shami plants from either this link or the seller from the Amazon which is selling the genuine Shami plant. However, if they themselves want to understand how a real Shami can be identified, which will be of course benefit for them, they should continue watching the video further. Now confusing and wrong information prevails on YouTube as well. However, few people on YouTube now started taking effort towards educating people on genuine Shami identification. I am one of them, and please share, like and subscribe and spread this information and education. So you can see here that there are YouTubers, and all of them have more than million views. They are talking about Shami benefit, how to use it, where to plant it, but none of them are having a genuine image of Shami plant. So I really doubt you know, those who cannot identify a genuine shami, how can they talk about its benefit and share it with people? Because people will follow them and they will buy veerturu and not shami. So we should be careful before sharing information with others. We should be careful that information is right, thorough research has been done, and then you share it with your viewers. So based on physical and morphological characteristics of shami tree, let's try to identify a genuine shami. So here you can see that this is a genuine shami and this is veerturu. So this is shami and this is a veerturu. Shami's biological name is Prosopis cineraria, and veerturu biological name is Trichrostachys cineraria. Now let's try to identify this. You don't need a big tree to identify based on these features which I am showing you right now. So in a branch, the place from where a leaf arises is called node. So this is a node because a leaf is arising from here. Again, this is a node because a leaf is arising from here. This is a node. The space between these two nodes is called internode. This space is called internode. This space is called internode. Now, one of the typical feature of shami is that it has thorns, and thorns are conical. It has conical thorns on internode. Shami will have conical thorns on internode, and it's, as I said, the shape of the thorn is conical. So one of the prominent identification feature of shami plant. Now this is a veerturu which is called Dichrostachys cineraria, and its thorns are longer and they are at nodes. They are not at internodes like shami, they are at nodes. And if you look closely at a veerturu thorn, the thorn doesn't look like thorn. Sometimes it looks like branch itself in the texture, and sometimes the thorns also has leaf on it. I will show you a video of a veerturu taken from a place nearby me. I will also show you a video of a large shami tree which I have found near my place in Gurgaon further in the video at the end. But let's try to identify shami based on more features. Now, one more prominent feature in a small shami plant, a newly growing shami plant, small plantlet, is that you will have foliaceous stipules in shami. What are foliaceous stipules now? So this is a leaflet, this is a compound leaf, because there are on stipule, it has multiple leaf on both sides. So such leaves are called compound leaf. When you have a small leaf at the base of the compound leaf, it is called foliaceous stipule. So this is the enlarged image of a foliaceous stipule. It will look like this. In a video also you can see that. So the place from where a stipule arises, so this is a stipule on which we have multiple small leaves, which is, now this is, the whole arrangement is called compound leaf. And below the source of origin of the leaf blade or stipule, you will see that there are small leaflets, and it will be a pair of a leaf flat, and this is called foliaceous stipule. This is a typical characteristics of a shami plant. Now we don't have anything like that on veerturu. Veerturu will not have foliaceous stipules. So this is the second major identification pattern, and you can use these two patterns on a small plant of shami. Now this identification feature is only available to you when the tree has grown big. You have bought the small plantlet, after a year flowers comes, and then you can identify whether it is shami or not. But we have told you some other features in the previous two slides based on which you can identify a genuine shami at initial stages also. But at a later stage, for your benefit, a shami will never have bicolored flowers. Like this one is pink and yellow, this is veerturu, and shami will have only yellow colored flowers, as you can see here in this image. The next feature is the seed pod, the pods of the shami, which Rajasthani call sangar and Haryanvis call that jinj or jhanj. So the seed pods of shami are elongated, tubular and cylindrical, but seed pods of veerturu are highly curled, they are flattened, and it is clearly visible, and you can identify it very well. And you can see the thorn here as well, like it's the thorn is very large the Shami tree thorns are conical and they are small. You can see these thorns are quite large. Next, for your benefit, I thought of sharing a complete picture of a tree. So this is the genuine Shami tree, which is called Prosopis cinerearia. And this is the Virdru, which is Dichrostachys cinerea. Now we have flowers on them also. You can see bicolored flowers here, and you can see flowers here which are yellow in color. Again, one more picture of Shami here and Virdru here for your benefit. So this is the image of a small Shami plantlet which we took from nursery life, and this is a genuine Shami, and this is the Virdru picture. I asked one of my friend Dinesh Dhakar to share this with me for benefit of people who are watching this video right now. And this is a genuine Shami, and this is Virdru. So you can see here that there are thorns on internodes. This is node because compound leaf is arising from here. Again, then the next leaf arises from here, and this is the internode, and you see thorns here. And if you watch it carefully, you can see foliaceous stipules here. This is foliaceous stipule. This is foliaceous stipule. This is foliaceous stipule. Moving over to the next slide, this is one of the image taken from a journal publication, scientific publication, and you can see the leaf seed pod of Shami. It's elongated, flowers are having a common width throughout the structure, and then you can see conical thorns on internode. So this is node, again this is node, and there are conical thorns. Now stipules on a large Shami tree, foliaceous stipules on a large tree will not be seen. It's not mandatory to have foliaceous stipule on a large tree. Only the newly growing branches will have that. Now for your benefit, you can read about Shami. The identification patterns are mentioned in this description, so you can read that yourself by pausing the video here. That will help you more, and you will get after reading this, you will get more confidence in this video, because we have taken all of that from here itself. And I will show the references in the description section of the video. You can take it from there as well. And now one exciting thing about Shami, the taproot of Shami can go up to 20 meter deep. So that's why you can see that this tree can grow in Rajasthan, where no other tree will be seen, because it can go very deep. Its root can go very deep in the soil and take water from there. So again, to summarize, thorns are conical and slightly curved in Shami. So you can see these are the conical thorns. Thorns are present between internodes. So you can see this is a internode. Sorry, this is a node, and this is the other node, because leaf arising here. This space is the internode, and you can see thorns here. So typical feature of Shami, and you can see foliaceous stipule. This is a foliaceous stipule. The compound leaf arises from here. It is called compound leaf because on stipule we have multiple leaf on each side. So this is a compound leaf. This whole thing is compound leaf, but the arising point of compound leaf will have small leaflets, which are called foliaceous stipules. One of the closely resembling tree with Shami, which is Kabuli kikar or Vilayati babool, because it has flowers of the same color, will not have thorns at internodes. Rather, it has thorns at node itself. So the leaf are arising here, and this is called node, and you can see thorns here itself, and they are not conical as well. They are elongated and pointed. So the definition of node or internode is mentioned here in the brackets. You can read that. Now leaves are alternate in Shami. So one leaf will arise here, the next will arise on the left side, the other one on the right side. And there will be 1 to 3 pairs of pinnae. This is pinnae. This is pinnae. So you see a pair of pinnae here, but sometimes you can see 3, or sometimes rarely you can see 4, but totally it's like 1 to 3 pairs of pinnae on the Shami, which you can see here. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4 here, then you can see 3 here, 1, 2, 3 here, 1, 2, 3, 4 here, like that. Now, again, from a International Journal of Green Pharmacy, we have taken some images to get more confidence of viewers. This is Sami, which is called Khejri in Rajasthan. This is Kabuli Kikar or Vilayati Babul. You can see flowers are yellow in color. For both have yellow colored flower. But Kabuli Kikar flowers are quite, they look compact, like they have a uniform pattern. But this is discrete. Fragmented type of look you will see. The pattern will not be smooth here. Here we will have a smooth pattern. You can see the difference in leaf as well here. The leaf of Shami, this is Shami leaf, looks different from the leaf of Kabuli Kikar or Vilayati Babul. Now, since people from different countries or within India, people from different states speaking different language may be watching this video. So for their benefit, so I am sharing, the different names Sami has throughout India or other countries like United Arab Emirates. So initially, let's talk about scientific name first. So botanical name, it's the current name is Prosopis cineraria. Historically, it was known as Mimosa cineraria. Then it was called Prosopis piscigora, and the current scientific or biological name is Prosopis cineraria. In Hindi, it is called Shami or Jhan. In Rajasthan, it is called Khejri. In Haryana, it is called Jati, Jat or Jati. So likewise, in many states, these are the names. In case you came up with some other names, you can mention in the comment. I will share that also with the people. And in United Arab Emirates, it is called Ghaf tree. Now, some interesting facts about Shami. Why Shami is so popular? So we have religious as well as we have scientific facts and some other facts which are quite interesting to know about Shami. So it is a state tree of Rajasthan. Shami is a state tree of Rajasthan, and it is called Khejri there, and they have a postal stamp dedicated to Shami. It is a national tree of United Arab Emirates, and they also have a postal stamp for Shami. So you can see one common pattern here. Rajasthan is a dry place, we have less water there, and United Arab Emirates is also a dry place, it's a desert, so the groundwater is low. So that's why Shami trees can survive there, and they have, Rajasthan calls it a state tree, and United Arab Emirates, it's a national tree for them. So this is one of the oldest known Shami tree, which is 400 year old, and this is growing in Bahrain, and it is called Tree of Life, and there is no source of water near it. So it is taking water from deep in the ground, which is surprising. And now one other interesting fact about Shami. In 1730, in a small village in Jodhpur, Rajasthan, Amrita Devi of Khejrali village and her three young daughters laid down their life for Shami. For protecting Shami, they sacrificed their life. The ruler of Marwar, Maharaja Bhesing, ordered to cut down trees for building his palace, and Amrita Devi and her three young daughters, to protect the tree, they sacrificed their life. After that, it changed into a revolution, and then 363 people also sacrificed their life to protect the tree. And these martyrs belong to Bisnoi community, very well known community in Rajasthan. And in 1970, this sacrifice of 1730 became a source of inspiration for the Chipko movement, I think, which was led by Sundarlal Bahuguna, one of the prominent environmentalists of India. Now, another interesting fact about Shami is that it is considered as sacred as Tulsi by many people throughout India, especially in Rajasthan. And it has various religious mentions. I am sharing some of them here, like Pandavas, hid their weapons under the tree when they were on exile. And, they worshipped the tree and thanked it for keeping their weapons safe. So that's why we think, we all think, based on this story, we we consider that Sami keeps us safe from surroundings, or maybe like fortune, or it has some astrological aspect. I don't know the detail on that. Now it is called Wonder Tree, King of Desert, and the Golden Tree of Indian Deserts. And since it is a state tree, there is a complete ban on cutting of healthy trees. However, the practice goes on brazenly. People cut its branches despite the ban on the cutting of trees, and the new plantation of new trees, new Shami trees, is also not going in an efficient manner. However, people have started taking this seriously now, and government also started selling distributing free Shami. And there is a local Rajasthan dish which is called sangri, made from Shami seed pods. So this is a description on other interesting stories about Shami. You can pause the video and read them for your benefit. They were in Hindi, so I have taken that image here, and the source also is mentioned here. So friends, the whole video which you watched till now, these are the references, like the online order taken from these places, then the documentary on Shami you can watch here, the documents on Shami, the scientific publication, journals and research papers on Shami can be accessed from here, and the images taken from different part of India which I have taken in my video are available from here. Now further, you can watch some videos on how a Shami looks and how a Veer Taru looks. So please watch that, and then please share, like and subscribe this video. So in this part of video, you can have a look at a live Shami plant, small Shami plant, and the yellow encircled part is foliaceous stipule, which I explained earlier in this video. You can see thorns in between internodes. So all the identification points of the small Shami plant can be seen here, and this will help you to identify a genuine Shami plant, the small Shami plant. And as I promised with you guys, this is a large Shami tree which you can see. This is near to Rain Basera Tank Road, Gurgaon, near to Reliance Mall, Reliance Outlet on Padodhi Road. So this is a large Shami tree. You can see the trunks are very scaly, the pattern of the leaves, and on this tree still there are some flowers, and some seed pods called sangri are still available. So you can grow Shami tree from its seeds, and you can collect seeds from sangri and then grow it, or you can also grow it from its branches, which is called vegetative propagation. So let me know if you want to have a video on how to grow a Shami tree, Shami plant, from its branches. I will do that. And on month of May, in the month of May, the seed pods will be available. So in my village also there are lots of Shami tree and Khejri tree. I will try to collect seeds from there in the next year on May, and we'll see if I can share it with people who want it. I will try that, but right now I can't promise, but in the month of May I will try to collect them. Right now it's not the season, so we can't do. But yeah, so this is a flower of Shami tree. You can see it's yellow in color, not very dense flower. And as shared earlier in the video, it looks exactly like that as shown in the images earlier in the video. And I will show you the sangri as well, the seed pod of the Shami tree, wherein seeds are formed. So again, I am zooming on the flowers. The yellow encircled area is the flower.
and this is Sangri. You can see in the circle, this is the Sangri from where you can collect Shami seeds. So please let me know if you want to have a video on how to grow Shami from seeds as well as from its branches. I will definitely do that if I see many comments on that. And please share, like and subscribe, because I did a lot of effort on creating all these videos, finding real trees and capturing them. And this is a real Veertharu, which is wrongly identified as Shami. So this is the Veertharu, not as Shami, but many people and many, you know, plant sellers sell them as Shami. You can see flowers are bicolored, pink and yellow both. Shami is only yellow colored, monocolored. So Veertharu is not like that. And in Veertharu, the spikes, the thorns are very large. Some of the branches itself have thorns and they are thorny, and it will have, leaflets on the thorn itself, which is not in the case of Shami. The thorns of Veertharu are large. They are on nodes itself. In Shami, the thorns are on internodes. They are conical. Here they are not conical. They are large and thorny and pointed, and they are longer than Shami. So this is a thorn. You can see I am pressing it with my thumb, and they are very large and they are not conical at all. And sometimes these thorns are actually extension of branches as well. They are, pointed, and it contains leaves. That will not be the case with Shami. So this is Veertharu. Again, you can see the flowers. They are bicolored, pink and yellow both. Within a flower, you have two colors, and Shami is only monocolored, only yellow in color. So I think now this video will make you very clear. Even the leaves are different. If you have a close look at leaves, there are many leaves. In Shami, you will have only three compound leaves, but here you will see many. So I think now it will be very clear to all my viewers that what is a genuine Shami and what is Veertharu. So you can, I think, easily differentiate. Still, if you have any doubts, let me know. I will share it or comment it, and I will try to explain you better. I think this is already in very detailed, but if still someone wants, I can help him or her. So very close look at the pointed branches. This will not be present in Shami. You can see the pointed branches, which looks like thorn, and it has leaf also on that. So this is the case with only Veertharu.